only get to events, but also that they're able to perform at the way they want to, be able to dedicate themselves to the game.
Yeah, definitely. Shout out to them. One of the few teams that have really sponsored some top players. But here we go. Loser bracket action, and straight away with the 1+2 throw.
Yeah, he's going to have to be careful. He has an opportunity. Wow, he gets up and goes for it. But the launch punish there. Low high.
Oh, we got some bad specific stuff.
Yeah, that was sick. Using the down forward one in conjunction with the rest of the combo. Something we don't normally see.
Very nice. And a 1+2 throw again. He seems to be going in with a lot of throws. Interesting.
Still hasn't had the opening. You know, the great movement here from Low High. Able to avoid a lot of the stuff here.
He's throwing a lot.
Yeah, okay. Gets the punish there. The follow-up. Uh-oh.
The back forward two. Safe launcher.
And the follow-up with the combo there. That's some decent damage as well. If he had the wall, it would have been way more.
Yeah. Those hop kicks from Ranchu.
Using the forward one.
Both on rage. Got to watch out for that rage drive.
Oh,
slide.
That might be it. Into the low, and great pressure there from Low High, able to close out that opening round.
Looking really close though. Guys, like I said, like you said, these guys are training partners. Well, they're on the same team, they could be training partners. There'll be some deep mind games involved here.
Either that or they hate each other. It could be either or.
Maybe
never
they do.
Mind. Oh, nice. While standing attack, able to get the follow up here. Into the screw running attack, yes sir.
What's the okie dokie? Oh, goes for the low.
No, I just feel like, you know, tools-wise, you know, Shaheen has so many great pokes in this matchup. I think it's really going to be tough for Rangchu to find those openings. But man, a huge risk there going for the counter hit.
Yeah, the forward 1-1-1, and that should be it.
Yeah, you got to be careful too, because, you know, that forward 1-1, even if you dedicate yourself to the second part, that is going to be heavily punished by Shaheen.
Yeah.
So you got to make sure it's counter hit.
And he's really good at timing it as well. Like, timing is very important in Korean second. Yeah. It's all about timing.
But being able to bait out a 10-frame counter hit on Will. You got to make sure it happens. And again, he's able to land it this time.
Land it again. This is a big damage as well.
Oh, he misses the follow-up this time. The running 1+2, not able to get it in time.
Gonna catch him ducking with the hop kicks. We're about even on health here as well.
Went for the back one, not able to get anything. Hop kick, get out of my face. Don't ever crouch dash in front of me again.
That was cheeky there, but nice block on the low. No punish, and then 1+2 again, not broken.
This time going for the... Oh, nice duck. Great punish there. Rangchu up 2-1 after having... I mean, it looked really tough for him to even get these rounds.
Yeah.
But 2-1 here. Well fought so far.
But he's ducking strings really well. He seems to know the Shaheen matchup pretty well.
Yeah. I mean, how can you not? I mean, you study... These are the players that have been studied and they've been displayed throughout the tournament or throughout the Tekken World Tour so many times.
They have been so consistent. So here we go. Goes for that best position.
That's so sick.
That's sick, yeah. Okie dokie. Nice chunks.
Nice, and I like how he did the crouch dash into the just waiting. Yep. Went for the low there, and now final round here, match number one.
Fight. Who's going to take it? It's been so back and forth here. Big whiff from Low Hype, no punish.
I mean, he has an opportunity, but you know, Shaheen, I think it's really on Shaheen with the momentum. He has the ability to pull out the lows when he wants. And, you know, Panda not really having that ability here. Oh, while standing too.
Nice, stuck on the while standing 1-1, but tries to go for that combo again.
Yep.
And the hop kick. How many times have we seen that hop kick? 7 golden letters for Low High.
Now, if you're Rangchu in this situation, obviously you had a great lead. You had a 2-1 lead in the round. Are you going to switch characters? Are you going to make it easier on yourself? Because it looked very, very difficult. He's on stage select. He's sticking with Panda.
I think in that situation, and we saw it before with Nii as well, when Josie, he lost the first match, but he started to make a bit of a comeback. He felt confident enough in his Josie that he actually won the next match.
The thing is, see, the difference between that matchup, I feel like Josie has the tools. Yeah. I don't think Panda does. Well, I really don't think Panda does. I mean, he has to take those risks. He got a lot of that damage by doing stuff like forward one, hoping for a counter hit, and really risking. I mean, going for the low with Panda is very, very risky because the linearity of the character.
The other thing is how comfortable you are with the character.
Yeah.
Even if it's not as good matchup-wise, if you're comfortable with the character and you know everything, like just like Joey Fury said, he's more comfortable with Jack.
Sure, and you know, Shaheen and Low High up 1-0 right now. Yeah. Rangchu's going to have to make some adjustments. One of the things I want to see is we haven't seen the Power Crush yet. I mean, Power Crush is such a good tool overall. Obviously, Shaheen can punish it, but if you get the read and able to go counter hit through a move, it's going to prove to help in a big way because it does knock down and you have the stance transition as well.
It's very true, and I don't think we've seen many lows from him either. You've been using a ton of mids. No down back 2, no down back 3.
Maybe he's trying to plant the seed for the future. Maybe he knew it was going to go the distance. There it is! Power Crush. He had the life lead, so he could have risked it, you know.
Yeah. So we go, Rangchu on the board there. Nice low parry straight off the bat. Nice read.
Much like the earlier round here. Let's see what he gets. Oh, he didn't get the wall break.
Yeah, didn't dash up in enough.
And you know, Panda, one of those characters that has like a lot of those built-in mix-ups. Is he going to finish the string? Is he not going to finish the string?
That's true.
What's he going to do afterwards? How is he going to create a reaction from his opponent?
And he just saw one there. He's done with a forward 1-1. Nice forward 1+2 and a nice combo head 2.
Yeah. And one of the things though is when he does get certain hits, he lacks having the ability to get an easy screw for a combo.
Yeah.
But he gets the follow-up here. That's going to do a lot of damage. One mix-up should do it. Nice one for the mid option there.
This looks so much different now from the last match. Ranju, but...
Oh, there it is! We've been waiting for that move, and it's now finally showing up. But is it going to be too little, too late? We'll find out. Now he has a good lead.
Yes, now he's comfortable. Two rounds up here in the second match. And like you said, not finishing that upward 3-4.
Oh, again! He is on low parry.
He is doing the
thing
right
now.
He
has the low parry mode activated. Nice, able to block in time.
Yeah, good patience. Back three again, trying to mount this pressure right now, but Ranju, how's he gonna respond?
Yeah, let's see what he does here. Good point. Nice, wall rising 4, got some good beefy damage out of that. Oh, see, you gotta be careful. That's why you have to make sure. If you're throwing out the forward 1, that has to be counter hit or you're done.
Yes, there we go. Ranju with rage, this should be dead, no! But good punish on the power rush.
Yeah, that was great. I mean, this adjustment period and a lot of the stuff that Ranju has been testing out in the matchup has been paying off, but he has to make sure he keeps the mix-ups in his favor. Right now, you can't let Lohai dictate the flow of the match again. That momentum is just going to be too much.
Yeah, again, so back and forth, and Lohai's looking so comfortable now. Huge life lead straight off the bat with just pokes.
Yeah, and that one time he did go for the low there with the down back too. He was able to get low parried. It's not looking good right now, so he's going to have to get out of that corner.
But this can still go to Ranju, but no.
Oh, look at that. He hit him right out of the aerial move.
That was sick. The sidewalk on the running 1+2. Now, this is it. Set point for Lohai. Can Ranju even out, though? I want to see
it. Oh, nice duck there. That's not easy to do. I mean, people throw that out very often, but that 4-1, not easy to deal with.
Yeah, especially if you don't even throw it out that often. He was super ready for it.
Yeah. Right now has a good lead here, close to 50% deficit.
And a nice low parry on the slide.
He's getting the follow-up for the running attack. Okay. One more mix-up might be able to do it. He went for the power crusher. It was interesting. He got hit right out of it in the activation frames.
Okay.
He might go for it again. Uh-oh. But Shaheen does have access to Rage Drive, though. This is going to be big, because if he can confirm it, it's going to hurt.
It's going to hurt a lot. Two tail spins. Oh, for the low parry.
He should be able to get it. Oh, nice stuff.
Man, you know, that whole match, Ranju just slow parried so many lows.
Yeah, and that's the thing, he didn't even do that many lows, but almost every single time, it's kind of like he was buffering for it. He was expecting it.
Yeah, he was expecting it.
Definitely not lows you can react to either.
There are some deep level mind games here. We go to a final match again. How many times have we been going to a final match? And we're going to the arena.
And that's the nature of Tekken sometimes. Sometimes when you got some good ass Tekken, you're going to go the distance, right?
Yes, absolutely. Woo.
All right, here we go. Back into the mix. And, you know, it's quite the feat, man. You know, seeing a panda in... You know, he's the only panda that we see this far in tournaments, especially in international events where we have some of the best players in the world. So he's definitely has work cut out of him. This is the second time we've seen him in a TWT Top 8 using panda. So it's actually it's a treat, I think, for a lot of fans, especially ones that don't get to see these characters so often.
Absolutely. And it just goes to prove that any character is viable in Tournament Tekken. There we go, goes for the throw, nice break from Lohai.
Yeah, went for the Circus Bear Rock and Roll Express, not able to get it.
Oh, another low parry.
Don't do lows anymore, maybe that's gonna work.
Fabi is blocked here, he's low parried all of them.
Goes maybe he's figured it out, his name is Lohai, all he does is lows and highs. Let me duck everything, right?
No mids.
Yeah, no mids.
There we go.
Oh man, he couldn't low parry that one too.
Yeah.
Nice.
Break for the 1+2.
Oh, the second hit, he wasn't ready for that.
Yeah.
Uncharacteristic.
Been ducking that 4-1 a lot, this time goes for the mid.
Is he going to throw with the Rage Drive out? Nice break again. Good pressure here. Oh, that's going to whip punish.
No.
Never mind, and not fast enough.
I think he tried to break the throw.
Yeah, it was an accidental throw break that helped him out. Oh my gosh. Sometimes, you know, that's a mind game because players will react. They'll hit like whatever a 1+2 is, and you'll see it even if the throws don't connect because they're reacting to the arms.
Yeah, absolutely.
They're not reacting to being thrown.
That's another layer. The lasagna.
That's too much. That's way too much. Get that out of my kitchen. Oh, he gets it. He finishes it. Oh my god. Never mind. Maybe there is another utility for that.
There we go, man. He's really throwing everything and the kitchen sink.
Yeah. Poor Xiaoyu. If you see the little doll of Xiaoyu on Panda's purse, getting thrown around like a rag doll.
Okay, punish on the hop kick.
Oh, again. Gets the back 1-2 follow up here. Looking to close it out.
Uh oh, slide.
Oh!
Ooh! hits him out of the rage drive.
Yeah, you gotta be ballsy to do that. Able to hit, clutch it out, but man. Oh, a hop kick to start it off. No more loads. Let me get rid of it.
Rangchu is in his head right now. Inception, ting.
Oh, again, another set of hop kicks.
Everything's hitting Mark. He ain't blocking.
Yeah, you're not gonna block what you can't see.
Okay, Rangchu, can
it's a panda.
It?
A bear is gonna kill a guy. Oh my gosh, hop kick out of the sky.
Nice.
Oh, he went for it again. He's been getting so greedy with that as well.
I know.
He ended up dropping it twice now in the set. But this is big. This is going to be decisive. It's either going to be a 3-0 or it's going to be maybe the momentum shift that he needs.
Oh, but no duck on the rage drag though. Go to the orbital.
Uh-oh.
One more hit can do it.
And he puts him in rage. He has another opportunity. Never mind. 2-1. And he takes it.